Hochtouren.
High alpine touring is considered one of the most challenging mountain sport disciplines for good reason, not least because rescue procedures can be fairly demanding. Not only do you need to be able to rescue companions, you also have to master self-rescue techniques. In other words, you should know how to prusik out of a crevasse. The pulley system is a relatively straightforward method that uses a simple pulley arrangement to haul your partner out of a crevasse. It is important to have enough spare rope to reach down to the victim and back up again. A useful piece of equipment when climbing in small rope teams is a rope pulley, preferably one with a reverse lock, such as a micro Traxion or a spock. Using these rope pulleys, even with a two-man rope team, you can pull your partner out of a crevasse. When a fall happens, it is essential to react quickly and choose a solid anchor. The type of anchor you select always depends upon the snow underfoot. The best arrests in massive ice can be achieved using a V-thread anchor or ice screw. In snow or firn, we usually use a T-slot anchor. Once the fall has been held, the front member of the team builds the T-slot anchor. To make it easier to work and provide a little more freedom of movement, the full load should be borne by the team member at the rear. But it is essential that the two team members communicate clearly with one another. The task of the person in the middle is to build an anchor. The first step is to create a personal anchor on the load line using a triple wrap prusik hitch. The accessory cord is tied off directly behind the prusik hitch and then tied into the belay loop on the harness and can unclip their figure eight loop. The advantage of this is that they can now stand up to build the T-slot anchor. This is done by digging a slot in the snow with the ice axe, then, at a right angle to the first slot in the pulling direction, a second slot for the sling. The sling is tied around the ice axe at its center of gravity using a girth hitch and pressed down into the slot with the pick pointing downwards. It should be as deep as possible, although obviously this depends upon the state of the firn. Then, this is very important, the area in front of the T-slot is compacted by covering it with snow and stomping down firmly. Now you can prepare to transfer the load. The carabiner holding the sling from the T-slot anchor should be clipped directly into the tied-off prusik loop. This way, the load is transferred to the prusik loop and subsequently to the T-slot anchor. The person at the rear can then slowly release the load. Once the load has been transferred, the person in the middle can now clip their loop into the carabiner of the T-slot anchor as additional backup. Then it is the job of the person at the rear to take over as rescuer. They take out the spare rope, tie a prusik to protect themselves, move toward the anchor point and go past it, pushing the prusik hitch as they near the edge of the crevasse, which they should approach with care. Now at the edge of the crevasse, the rescuer should make contact with the fall victim and prepare the lip of the crevasse to make it easier for the fall victim to climb back up over the edge. The best pulley system to use is a micro Traxion or a spock. This is a rope pulley with an integrated rope clamp or reverse lock. This pulley is standard equipment nowadays, particularly for smaller rope teams, because it significantly reduces friction while at the same time offering a reverse locking mechanism. If you don't have a pulley, you'll have to use the time-honored traditional method. This involves lowering down a locking carabiner, then setting up a prusik loop at the top of the rope to function as a reverse lock. Once set up, the pulley is lowered down on the fixed rope until it can be reached by the fall victim. They clip it into the belay loop on their harness and give the signal to start pulling. Those at the top can now haul them out. The person closest to the edge of the crevasse can also do this alone. If the spare rope is long enough, the person at the rear, who is still standing beside the T-slot anchor, can also assist with the pulling. The front person at the edge of the crevasse now has the job of pulling up the load. If they used the traditional method, With a prusik as a reverse lock, they will obviously have to keep sliding it up the rope after each haul to ensure the prusik grips the rope and holds the load. The fall victim should assist with the rescue by pulling on the rope they were attached to when they fell into the crevasse, so that the person at the top of the crevasse does not have to haul the entire load by themselves. If the fall victim is not able to clip into the carabiner, or if there's not enough spare rope, you will need to modify the pulley system using a rope clamp and haul the fall victim out of the crevasse as best as you can. This would involve the rescuer leaning over the edge of the crevasse and fastening a tiblock to the load line along with the carabiner and the rope that is used for the rescue. They then slide it as far down the rope as possible by shaking the rope or lowering the carabiner and tiblock to the fall victim until it is right beside them. They can then fasten the reverse lock system to the rescue rope and continue with the rescue as normal. However, remember that an unconscious fall victim will not be able to assist with their own rescue and may even be in danger of tipping over backwards, making the rescue effort more difficult. The pulley technique is an essential and important rope technique on high alpine tours. Although it is not particularly complex, it is difficult enough to be less than intuitive, and that means practice is required. Not just once every 5 years, but over and over until it becomes second nature, so that you can do it quickly and efficiently when necessary.